Good evening. You're watching a special edition of Left, Right and Center. I'm Nidhi Razdan. On the program tonight, the big political story just ahead of crucial state elections in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan. Mayawati, the BSP chief, has announced that she will be going it alone. She will not be tying up with the Congress party. The Congress had been in negotiations with her for weeks now, particularly in the crucial states of Madhya Pradesh and Rajasthan. Madhya Pradesh in particular, where the BSP is more of a factor. But Mayawati today attacking the Congress party, not directly attacking Sonia and Rahul Gandhi, but Digvijaya Singh, the former chief minister of Madhya Pradesh in particular, and saying that they were not interested in an alliance, that she was going to go it alone, and saying many, many other things.
Madhya Pradesh aur Rajasthan mein hamari party Congress party ke saath milkar kisi bhi kimat par chunav nahi ladegi. Imandari se gathbandhan ke saath chunav ladne ke liye bhi Congress party अभी हमें तैयार नहीं लगती है. कांग्रेस के जो मुखिया हैं, जो राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष हैं श्री राहुल गांधी, वह संरक्षक श्रीमती सोनिया गांधी जी, ये दोनों चाहते हैं, दिल से चाहते हैं कि बीएसपी का और कांग्रेस पार्टी का जो देश में लोकसभा चुनाव होने से पहले कुछ राज्यों में विधानसभा के आम चुनाव होने वाले हैं, तो वहां कांग्रेस और बीएसपी का गठबंधन होना चाहिए. कांग्रेस पार्टी के वरिष्ठ नेता श्री दिग्विजय सिंह जैसे लोग तो ये चुनावी समझौता कतई भी होते हुए नहीं देखना चाहते हैं.
वी आर रेडी टू टेक ऑन all the parties who are going to contest against us. And I'm sure that the people in Madhya Pradesh will understand that the BJP is looking to splinter votes. The BJP is looking to fragment votes. Well, if she's announced it that she's going it alone, I think she's announced it she's going it alone. So now there's no more talks after this. We got to see the seats where a seat with us and BSP can defeat the BJP. Just having numbers, and those numbers do not mean that we can defeat the BJP. I don't think it's a huge setback. I don't think it's a huge setback because even the smallest BSP worker will understand what the implications of this are. And I certainly think that we are well positioned to beat the BJP. And it is not my last desire. My last desire is to bring the Congress back in Madhya Pradesh, not merely to become Chief Minister.
Joining us on the program this evening, we have from the Samajwadi Party, Mr. Ghanshyam Tiwari, who's a spokesperson of the SP, Rashid Kidwai, of course, who knows Madhya Pradesh well. He's an author and visiting fellow at the ORF. Mr. Deshratan Nigam, who is a political analyst and a supporter of the RSS, joins us. Senior journalist Sabha Naqvi is with us. And from the BSP, we have Anubhav Chak, who will be joining us very shortly from Kanpur via Skype. Ghanshyam Tiwari, let me get the Samajwadi Party's reaction to this first. How do you look at this development today? How much of a setback is this for the big plan to have a Mahagathbandhan?
Well, three things. One, I don't see this as a setback because the big plan of Mahagathbandhan is about opposing BJP that has misruled India for 4.5 years and failed its own promises. And that is about ensuring that in every constituency going to 2019 elections, there is one dominant candidate against a BJP candidate. Second, with respect to what Mayawati ji has said, I think Akhilesh Yadav ji had also spoken on this matter at NDTV UA Summit, where he said that Congress ko bada dil rakhna chahiye. It is important that the party, which Rahul Gandhi ji described as the party that aspires to be the platform for opposition for 2019, has to be more forthcoming in building alliances, and it is a problem that they have to solve. Third, as far as
the... So is this the Congress's fault? What has happened? Would you say that the onus lies on them, that this alliance with Mayawati hasn't worked out?
Well, as this story unfolds into a national election story for 2019, the onus will always be on Congress to build alliances because they have a much harder and wider job to do to build alliances in state after state. They were forthcoming in Karnataka post-elections, building an alliance with JDS. We expect something similar.
You don't think they're forthcoming right now?
Well, clearly the statements of Mayawati ji and the statements of coming from Congress party do not show that forthcoming attitude.
Okay, well, that's quite a statement coming from another important potential ally, Akhilesh Yadav, Samajwadi Party. And I think, you know, the Congress, Rashid Kidwai, which has chosen actually not to participate in this debate today itself is quite telling with all the multiple statements coming out. But, you know, we just interviewed Digvijaya Singh, who's standing by his earlier comments that he believes that this is because of pressure from the various security agencies, investigating agencies on Mayawati. How much is it really that? Or is it, as Ghanshyam Tiwari seems to suggest, the Congress actually messing up an opportunity, not really being able to sew together an alliance with a regional party properly, which it has had in the past, a problem it's had in the past?
Nidhi, in Madhya Pradesh, there is no history of alliance politics. The Congress has been in power, out of power, but they have never had this kind of alliance. That bargaining that was taking place, I think it was very difficult for the Congress to accommodate, you know, 40-50 assembly seats out of 230 to Mayawati. If at all Mahagathbandhan will take place, it would be for Lok Sabha elections. I think in Congress scheme of things, the Mahagathbandhan in state was not there. It is very confident that either in November 2018, when assembly elections will be held, it will be either a vote against Shivraj Singh Chauhan or for Shivraj Singh Chauhan. If it is a vote against Shivraj Singh Chauhan, the Congress will be the sole beneficiary. Not Mayawati, it will not be a split verdict.
No, certainly it wouldn't be, but what if it's not a close race? I mean, what if it is a close race? And then what? The BSP has what, a 6% vote share in Madhya Pradesh?
In the close race, as we have seen then in Manipur or Goa, Manipur, Goa, and all, the BJP will be able to form its government because the incumbent government, if they fall short by 10, 20, 15 seats, I think they will easily make it up. The Congress, Nidhi, you must understand this, that Congress needs to stand on its own strength. If it has to win some states in order to be relevant, in order to be a challenger to the BJP in national politics. And Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh, these are the three very fertile grounds where there is an element of anti-incumbency. The Congress cannot be just, you know, making compromises with its own strength.
Okay, so you believe that this would actually work out? You think that the Congress would be pleased with this because they couldn't have afforded to give away 50 seats or so that she was apparently demanding? Ghanshyam Tiwari,
well,
is a good point on that.
I don't think that the narrative of alliance is compromised. The narrative of alliance is a common front to oppose BJP both at state level and national level. I don't think that the things that as they stand are win-win for any political party in this alliance discussion. I think it's important that Congress moves beyond what is currently being a charge that Mr. Digvijaya Singh put out, which was not a good a charge in good taste on as far as alliance is concerned.
Well, another strong criticism there from the SP. But Mr. Nigam, the point is that Rashid Kidwai may say that the Congress needs to sort of stand on its own feet at the state level and the Lok Sabha is a different game. But would you agree with that? Or is this a sign of things to come, that if the opposition can't get its act together for an entire assembly election, how is it going to do it for the Lok Sabha? Or is it entirely possible that there's a different game plan when it comes to national elections?
The real situation out here is that whenever Congress has aligned with the regional parties, it is the regional parties which have suffered. And they have almost gobbled up the regional parties. So that's a very practical decision so far as the state elections are concerned. I do not know about 2019. And secondly, Congress goofed up in its reaction today when I heard Surjewala. When there was a scathing attack on the Congress. And they said they have not criticized Rahul and Sonia. And which means there is a dynasty and a family on one side and Congress on the other side. That distinction, they made it very clear. Ordinary Congress on the one side and the Rahul and Sonia
Why
Gandhi on the...
Why does that surprise you?
No, it does.
It's not the first time.
So that it's a dynasty that matters. It's a family party. So, and regional parties have to be very careful out here. That's not a democratic institution. And therefore, when you're discussing, having one-to-one discussion, the possibility of whims and fancies of individual leader of the Congress comes into play rather than the practical combinations. So that danger will always be there. And Mayawati is also trying to take the space of the Congress as the main opposition. That's what she has signaled here.
I don't think that's possible. But Ghanshyam, just give me a second. I want to ask Anubhav Chuck of the BSP, who's joining us from Kanpur. Anubhav ji, who are kya? Matlab, Mayawati ji, itne gusse mein kyun hain?
देखिए निधि जी, शुरू से ही जब से कर्नाटक का इलेक्शन हुआ है और जब से देश में चारों तरफ महागठबंधन के बारे में चर्चा हुई है, सभी लोग इस बात को देख रहे थे और जान रहे थे कि माननीय बहन जी लगातार बार बार एक चीज़ को कह रही थी कि सम्मानजनक सीटें यदि दी जाएंगी तो समझौता होगा, लेकिन उसी बीच में आग में घी डालने का काम कुछ नेताओं के द्वारा करा जाता रहा। जैसे ही छत्तीसगढ़ में समझौता हुआ था जी जोगी जी के साथ, उसी समय छत्तीसगढ़ के जो प्रदेश अध्यक्ष थे उन्होंने ये बात को पहले सबसे पहले कहा था कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के दबाव में बहन जी ने ये निर्णय लिया है, जबकि सच्चाई ये है कि 2003 में भी बहन जी ने भारतीय जनता पार्टी के खिलाफ जाके अपनी सरकार का जो बिल्कुल कुर्बानी दे दी थी, लेकिन भारतीय जनता पार्टी के आगे घुटने नहीं टेकी थी। और आज दिग्विजय सिंह ने उससे भी एक हाथ आगे बढ़ कर एक स्टेटमेंट दे दिया, उसके बाद कुछ सोचने समझने के लिए कुछ बचा ही नहीं था। इनको तो एक उदाहरण सेट करना चाहिए, जैसे हमारी पार्टी में जब जय जो नेशनल वाइस प्रेसिडेंट बनाए गए थे उन्होंने एक स्टेटमेंट दिया था, बहन जी ने तुरंत ही एक कार्रवाई करके उनको पार्टी से भी निकाल दिया था और सारे पदों से भी मुक्त कर दिया था। इसी तरीके का उदाहरण अगर कांग्रेस सेट कर देती जिस समय छत्तीसगढ़ के अलायंस के समय, तो शायद जो आज घटना हुई है ये रोकी जा सकती थी। और दिग्विजय सिंह अपने इसी तरीके के अनोखे बयानों के लिए ही जाने जाते हैं। इस तरीके के बयान भी नेताओं को गठबंधन जो संभावित है उसके दरमियान में कांग्रेस को लाने से बचना चाहिए था।
लेकिन मैं आपसे ये पूछ सकती हूँ कि जिस तरह आज मायावती जी ने जो स्टेटमेंट दिया है, क्या ये हम मान सकते हैं कि अभी जहाँ तक लोकसभा का सवाल है वो दैट डोर इज नॉट क्लोज्ड येट, अभी उस पर बातचीत होनी है, हम सिर्फ मध्य प्रदेश की बात कर रहे हैं अभी?
जी हाँ, मध्य प्रदेश के ही बारे में अभी बता रहे हैं, लेकिन जो लोकसभा के इलेक्शन की बात हो रही है उसके लिए भी कांग्रेस को बड़ा दिल दिखाना पड़ेगा। अगर बहन जी ने सार्वजनिक रूप से प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस करके अपनी पीड़ा जाहिर करी तो क्या कांग्रेस को अभी तक कोई कार्रवाई नहीं कर देनी चाहिए ऐसे बड़बोले नेता के ऊपर? कांग्रेस को कोई कार्रवाई करनी चाहिए थी, तब तो आगे गठबंधन के कोई रास्ते खुलेंगे। अगर इसी तरीके से माननीय बहन जी के ऊपर जो हम सबकी सम्मानित नेता हैं उनके ऊपर पर्सनल अटैक करे जाएंगे तो गठबंधन किस तरीके से संभव होगा?
अच्छा, आप तो अब कार्रवाई भी मांग रहे हैं दिग्विजय सिंह के खिलाफ,
होनी चाहिए।
ठीक है, तो सभा, हाउ डू यू रीड दिस? आई मीन व्हाई इज व्हाट दिग्विजय सिंह हैज सेड मेकिंग मायावती सो पब्लिकली एंग्री? व्हाट डू यू थिंक इज द रियल स्टोरी हियर? इज इट रियली अबाउट केसेस और इज इट एज आई आस्क्ड अर्लियर फ्रेंकली द कांग्रेस नॉट बीइंग एबल टू हैंडल अलायंसेस?
Nidhi, I think it's very much the latter. I think as we head towards 2019, there are two preparations happening. If we go by the national parties, if we still call the Congress a national party, the BJP is moving on the ground with its very good strategy of encouraging vote-cutting parties. It's a strategy that emerges from Gujarat of encouraging forces that take away 2,000, 3,000, 4,000 votes. The Congress is existing on a level where it is detached from the ground. It thinks it's reinventing its image. That is number one. So, for Mayawati, please remember, she has to just wait and watch the political game. She has to see whether the Congress has any life in it, whether it will win states which it should win. But the Congress is capable of the reverse happening, because the BJP is putting strategies on the ground. The vote cutting strategies are extremely critical. I don't have the time to tell you how in seats in Gujarat 20 Patel candidates were put up in specific seats, independents, when there was a Patel upsurge. This is how the BJP operates, which is how you should understand your ground politics. The Congress now, towards the end of this, when we head towards UP, obviously Mayawati needs an alliance with the Samajwadi Party to get a chunk of MPs into her own kitty. But please mind you, when the Samajwadi concedes 40 seats in Uttar Pradesh, but when they do that for Bhenji, there is already a vote-cutting force there called Shivpal Yadav. When cadre-based parties are not able to give tickets to their cadre and their supporters, that vote-cutting force also attracts things. Whereas the BSP has the most transferable vote share. Of course, all of this is incumbent on chemistry. All of this is happening. But there is already a strategy to tackle all the other things in place from the ruling party of India, whereas the Congress imagines it's going to be resurrected. Of course, it's likely there is so much anti-incumbency, it could win these assembly elections, but their strategies on the ground are weak. They are a very, very elitist party. They just don't get certain basics, bunch of Rajas, Maharajas, nice chaps, socially very easy chaps, who just don't understand certain basics of how you deal with subaltern leaders.